Kat sini pun rolling sudah ya.
Izan kan masa nervous ni.
Saya pun. Padahal padahal you do this every day. Betul. Hello. Aduh. Hey, what's up? You're watching The Sip Sip Show. Nama saya Egan. Kenapa saya budu dari ni? Ada Ate, Ate. Hai Ate.
Hai Ate.
Ada Debbie. Kau monitor saya teh. Saya takut dia terhilang suara ke apa terjadi. So this is a show where we get Sabahan to tell their story. So I guess every Sabahan has a story lah gitu kan. But today kan macam lain ni yang lain pukulan dia. So today we have someone very special. Lain lah. Hello Velvet.
Hi. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for saying yes to this. How long have we known each other?
I think more than 15 years, or?
Oh, yo.
Yeah. Wait, I met Egan through his wife.
My wife.
Yeah.
So my wife is Anne. So they goes to school. They goes to school together. So you have been active with music dari dulu lagi kan?
In a way, yes, yeah. It's like this lah. I like to sing. Memang dari dulu lagi lah.
Right.
Yeah.
Sound okay there? I want to ask about someone. This particular someone. Ibu.
Mm-hmm.
What stories can you tell about her?
Okay, Ibu is my teacher lah kan. I mean, Anne and I know her since we were student di apa St. Michael. We go to the same high school together, and she's like our music teacher lah. So she go by the name Cikgu Lucy Gawis. So I think from what I can remember, she's the teacher who actually, you know, supported students yang suka the creative punya side. Yeah, she's got, I mean, she betul-betul mau tolong lah. She's got a passion for this type of students. Yeah, sebab bukan lepas semua budak macam, you know, kalau pergi sekolah bukan semua science stream kan. Ada apa kelas sastra semua kan, art punya aliran. So she's like, I think the only teacher lah kalau saya bercakap yang memang sangat-sangat passionate dalam ini bidang. I think sampai sekarang, dan banyak sudah dia punya student-student yang memang dia support sampai sekarang. Yeah, one of them I think I can say Fanzi. Yeah, I kenal Fanzi through Cikgu Lucy.
She's still teaching?
I think dia baru sejak pension.
Oh.
She just retired like, ya barulah, few months ago kali.
Apa yang kau ingat betul-betul pasal dia kalau dia mengajar?
Kalau yang saya ingat kan, I mean she supported whatever I was doing lah, especially kalau dalam bidang nyanyian lah in sekolah, and she's our choir teacher. Guru music juga, yes. Oh, memang guru music pun. So, what I can ingat pasal dia kan, she's like, dia memang bagi support dia, kau lah. Like, apa saja kau buat begitu. Especially dalam music. Susah mau cari cikgu begitulah.
Kesayangan gak kau nih?
Tidak juga lah kau
macam,
ni.
Macam tidak you lah, have that very happy face.
Saya sama Anne lah kali ya. But she moved after macam bila saya form 3, she moved to maktab perguruan. Okay. Kayak to be a lecturer deh. But oh, up until today kami masih still very close lah. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean I would see her son kan dia rajin berbisnes and dengan saya sekali bayang I feel very attached to her ni.
Oh yeah, si Anne pun lah your wife also. Your yeah, wife.
And then I did a photography job lah di di KB ni, and then ada dia. And automatically kan the whole event kan jadi macam ah this is family. Terus yang saya boleh buat sekati saya jadi terus yang siok lah. I mean I guess I understand what you feel, what you felt with her because she's very warm.
Very yeah.
Yeah, sangat sangat ibu lah. Mula-mula I think I met her the first time during your wedding.
Oh really?
I think that was the first time.
Oh okay.
So bila jumpa, oh inilah ibu, dia bilang si Anne. So I'm like, you need to have this certain, how you say, you need to be worth the name ba. Kenapa
yeah,
ibu?
Yeah, yeah. That's so ibu big kan, ba.
Yeah. Satu kali jumpa dia kan siang, oh okay. Dengan saya sekali saya rasa macam siapa mereka sayang ini.
Yalah kan you know a teacher kan yang kau boleh tahu kalau dia buat sekadar mau ajar saja ataupun macam you can know yang she's like really passionate in the things that she do, the things that she does lah kan. So like she's one of them lah yang memang dia betul-betul suka apa yang dia buat.
Saya mau segue sekejap pergi your real ibu.
Aha.
She is also a character yang sangat welcoming.
Oh yeah, my mom. Oh my mom pun. I think we all got that apa from her. My dad also lah. Sama juga. My dad is also quite warm.
Yang yeah, ketua kampung material.
Ulah.
Let's go back to the album.
Wow.
So okay, you're coming up with an album, begitu kah?
Yeah, I think it's out already.
It's out already?
I mean, when are okay, you putting this out?
Because I got the a different kind of... Oh, iyalah kan?
Mm-hmm.
Eh, bingung macam ni.
It's out on the 30th of... It's out on the 30th of November 2023.
Alright.
And my voice sucks again today.
Kenapa? Yeah.
Sarut siya, doi. I think I've been... Ano lah, macam... I've been straining my voice, my vocals, so I sound like a broken record. Tidak saya sarut.
Seksi gitu lah.
Kesian. Yang ada ingus-ingus lagi tuh yang sini.
Okay. Kenapa the album comes after your ibu-ibu kan, saya rasa macam in this album I saya baru bikin saya punya homework.
Mm-hmm.
And I really felt something yang bukan bilang negative but it hits a very weak muscle in your heart
as a guy.
Yes.
Oh really?
Because if you hear some kind of a these kind of words said in a conversation from a woman, it will memang terasa ba.
Mm.
And mula-mula saya dengar kan macam oh ni satu lagu yang begini punya yang dark. And then the next one ada lagi terus yang ada a few I'm not sure like is it like more than 3. So saya rasa macam, what is this face? Kenapa? So I'm trying to see like, ibu, your mom, and then you.
Mm.
So I'm like, yeah, I want to know why if you guys are listening to the songs of the new album, it's good. It's really bikin sakit hati. It's that tahap yang it's good tapi bikin gerigitan. Kenapa nih jantan begini? Atau kenapa, why is this person like this? So why are these songs like this?
I don't know. I think kan. Wait, because kan sebelum while I was making this lah kan, I have like few friends lah yang close sama Sela, and they're obviously guys. Bila they were listening to it kan, macam diorang terbingung like what are you trying to portray here? Macam they don't quite understand the emotion of the song yang ada di dalam lah. So I said, macam coba interpret the song ikut yang lelaki punya rasa lah. I don't know how. So macam dia orang fikir, but what's going on your mind ni, dia bilang. Well, I think this is, I can say it's probably the other side of my writing lah. Yeah. And I like to express my feelings through words. And bukan saya bilang saya cun juga menulis pun, but I just like to.
Kakadi.
Saya rasa macam kalau kita express perasaan kita dalam buku ka while we write kan, macam it's feels liberating lah. Macam daripada kau kasih keluar sama people kan, like you vent it out on, just say lah, social media kan, it's, you know, it's just gonna create something bah. So I just wanna create something that I've never created lah in my life. Like, I mean, I have written like all sorts of, you know, heartaches gitu kan, but I've never showed it to the public gitu. Because why? Maybe I just didn't have the time to do it. Maybe probably, you know, kau terlampau fikir pasal apa society akan fikir pasal kau when they listen to whatever you came out with. So macam this year I just felt macam maybe I should just do whatever I want instead of thinking about what other people want, kan? And that's how I came out with the album lah. Macam I just didn't quite care about the impact of my writing. Let's say lah kalau orang terdengar like, and then, you know, it's just my writing lah, begitu. And it's probably something that, you know, semua orang pernah rasa. Yeah. So kalau kau dengar, memang it's about heartbreak lah. It's about heartbreak, it's about, you know, feeling so small in a relationship. It's about being betrayed, begitu. Tetapi, tidak semestinya it happened in my life, gitu. Yeah. It's probably me channeling feelings from my surroundings. Yeah. And that's how I express it lah, through songs, gitu. I treat my tulisan semua ni kan macam art lah. It becomes something that you jahit together, and then, you know, jadi baju. Just go, okay, here you go. Itu wasn't an easy process lah. It requires emotions.
When you talk about process, coming up with these words, forming it into a, when you say daripada kau pergi social media begitu kan, I guess this is what I'm getting from what you said just now. Daripada kau ranting, daripada kau bikin status punya postings yang pasal these topics, you go straight to creating masterpieces like this lah, pergi jadi lagu gitu kan.
Yeah, because yeah, I'm not so much on social media juga, and Because why kan? Because social media consumes you ba? Walaupun it's not about you kan, you know, ketelampau mau ikut whatever yang itu arus kan, it eats you nih. So I'd rather do something else that can actually make me happy, gitu. And I find macam ketenangan in writing, yeah, writing and also creating music lah, begitu. Bukan saya bagus pun, I just do ikut. Betul. Saya ikut hati sejalan. And I don't, saya pergi sekolah music pun tidak pernah. I never go to. I don't even know how
imagine
to baca.
Imagine if you did.
Tauke begitu.
Tauke.
So it's actually, I rasa macam saya ajar diri sendiri. Saya belajar lah how to do all these things on my own with the help of some of my good friends lah. Yeah.
We take a short break. Kami akan kembali selepas ini, Conan. Gitu. And we're back, gitu, Conan. Oh ya, kena edit lah ni kan, mau bikin dia.
When do you wanna anu ni? When are you gonna air it?
I guess since this is like close to the album and you need to promote it, then secepat mungkin lah.
Okay lah.
I'll bypass yang lain.
Perks of having N as a
hari
friend.
Itu si Ego pun ada.
Siapa Ego?
This guy. He lives in a playground, and he joins dance battle and wins. Dia sangat hebat lah, gila ni orang manusia ni.
Wow.
And to think yang diorang mesti mau menang every competition yang diorang join to pay rent, to buy food, and they live in a 10 by 10 room, 8 orang.
Wow.
Yang semua yang
this is
10 by 10. So imagine, kita 4 orang pun sudah macam kita lah 8 orang kan orang tinggal. Okay. So yeah, that's Ego. Can we go back to you?
Can.
Sure. How do you deal with self-censorship? Because you have like this phase yang bukan phase, macam a hurdle lah yang kau temau fikir pasal apa orang fikir pasal kau pilih, kau mau buat apa sih yang kau mau. But I feel like there's that layer of self-censoring yang macam isi temau tulis begini just because.
Actually,
do you have that?
Yeah, kan deh macam before I will always go to Debbie, you know, to tell her because she, yalah, we work together lah kan. And whatever piece that I feel like working apa mau kasih jadi dia, I would always talk to Deb lah about it. So this album actually it was not in a plan. I've never planned to actually come out with an album, an English album lagi. Siapa lah mau dengar kan, you know, like, you know, kita di sini we don't really, you know, kalau orang lokal keluar English album, it will be like something like, macam wow, berangan-angan gitu. I think lah, that's what our people punya perception is lah. Sad to say, but memang betul juga lah.
Who was the last singer to come out with an English album in Sabah?
I don't know, and I don't really follow juga lah actually. I think it's good to not.
I don't know. I mean, saya tidak tahu sangat.
I think the more kamu buat research pasal siapa, apa keluar apa, kau punya artwork becomes something that kamu ikut arus, I think. So the more you don't give kasarannya, the more you don't give a damn, I think dia bagus juga in a way when writing lah begitu. Karena kalau kamu ikut apa yang orang mau, I think dia tidak akan mencerminkan yourself lah, sebab kamu mau bubut itu viral, kamu mau, you know, you wanna have the most viewed video gitu kan. So it becomes something that is made. So macam bila I came out with this album pun, it was really an impulsive decision. It came out as an idea. So when I see my writings kan, macam wah, if I come out with my own name, people will speculate. Because dalam the lyrics, it's not, dia bukan bunga-bunga. It's memang
straightforward.
Straightforward. It's so sad. It's very, you know, it's very sakit. It's very, it's heartbreaking. So I told dia bilang macam, ish, better cari like pseudonym punya nama gitu. And said, yeah, can also lah kan. Said, yeah, so we got a name lah konon ni. But as I thought through apa things kan, macam terpayah lah, macam it's a hassle again to register your name, you know, to do another yalah, another account on whatever you have already bah. Like your songs, you buat baru just to be someone else. So I said, ah, kasih sejalah. Like, you know, you only live once. And I think, kalau saya tulis yang begini pun, you know, I consider this as an art. Yeah.
I guess I can relate to the storytelling in the songs. Let's go to your husband. Apa dia punya perasaan waktu dia dengar ni lagu tu yang
apa?
Let's just say people assume that he's involved in these words.
Well, I came out with the album, so he's got apalah, dia okay saja. Because like I told him macam what I tell you also lah, I treat this piece as an art, and it depends on people macam mana diorang mau anu lah tafsir it. It can be about me, it can be about them, you know. And I think kan dalam dunia ni, heartbreak is one of the most sakit punya perasaan in the world tau. But sometimes kan you don't know how to express it. You don't have a medium to go to actually feel good about it, begitu. And I think it's like such a sensitive punya area where people don't really want to touch juga. Sebab dia bilang, maybe dia akan buka kau punya aib, begitu.
Because it involves
two people. Yeah, but I think kan, in this age that we're living in kan, infidelity, betrayal kan is so rampant bah. And the society these days, kalau compared sama dulu, you know, kita sekarang fikirkan it's a norm, you know, it's a norm to do all those things without having to hurt another third party punya feelings gitu. So macam sometimes people who gets, you know, yang orang yang kita nampak lah, yang goes public about it, when they talk about it kan, sometimes you can see macam they being made fun of. Tapi kan actually sakit hati itu is really sakit. Yeah. But I don't know, macam dalam ni lagu kan, saya tak tahu siapa yang akan rasa lah actually. I just write it, I just express myself through it lah. But I don't know who will be able to, you know, get it gitu. Yeah. Because macam when I decided to come out with this album pun kan, macam all the things that I do, I don't put expectations on it lah. Because once you put a benchmark on it, like who's gonna listen, you know, I wanna target this market only, I wanna target the teenagers, kan, you know, you become frustrated. Yeah. So macam I told myself lah since a long long time ago, macam I don't put expectation in my works lah, in the things that I do. Begitu. So bila dia keluar pun macam yes, I anticipate for the release, for the album release. But macam it's already done and dusted bah. Saya sudah kasih siap everything. So it's just tinggal to present it and just fly lah gitu.
Right. My feelings when I heard these songs. At first bila aku mau tekan kasih start gitu kan. All these previous hits yang dari Kamatan. No, your songs. Yang dari Kamatan, dari AF, Pia Time, yang all these Velvet that I knew. Or the Velvet I thought I knew. And these are all like feel good kind of songs yang happy-happy, duduk satu meja. All those videos yang funny, apa semua tu kan. And when you say kau tak peduli apa orang cakap, and this came out, I feel it's much more powerful. Yes, yang lepas-lepas powerful, but in a generic way yang semua orang pun boleh rasa begini. This one, it feels like you guys can disagree, ah?
Can ba? Okay.
This one feels like, okay, everyone feels like this, but does everyone find the courage or the space and time to express this? Saya rasa macam apa yang kau cerita ni kan, your storytelling in this round kan, sangat what's the right word, breakthrough. Sangat macam astaga, dia bercerita pasal barang begini, bolehkah? Yang ngamkan ni begini. Apa, even saya yang at first I thought it was you, now it's clear that it's not you, but it's that feeling is still there, it lingers.
How you know it's not me?
Okay.
Yeah. What continue.
Okay, we need to go like specific song. Which one? But these are the types of songs yang macam mana? It's a threshold in our society. Saya selalu komplain pasal lagu-lagu kita kan, lagu-lagu Sabahan yang Bulan Bintang, Janji Ini Itu, Saya Sehidup Semati lah, bla bla bla. And now this, yang apa kau buat sama laki orang? Terus yang the fuck, man, it's the time is now. Yeah, I mean, it's in our lifetime yang saya dengar lagu yang specifically pasal ini punya niche. Yang I would come back like I have my favorite movies yang sedih. Kalau saya mau get into that feeling yang kau mau rajin buat kerja, kau tengok John Wick gitu kan, so motivated gitu. Kau mau tengok yang nangis punya, kau you go to this movie. I think this is the type of young songs yang you would go for this. Yang kau mau ingat balik barang-barang begitu yang jantan sial gitu atau perempuan tenggula, terus yang then you, I don't know. Tapi I have that feeling ni yang you just give an avenue for people to yang to dwell in this for a few minutes and try to apa sih yang buat sama hidup saya sekarang, ah, because now it's expressed.
Yeah.
Am I making sense?
Yeah. I can understand that. But can I don't know, from a guy's perspective lah. Macam when you heard, that's why I wanted you to, you know, listen through the whole album batu, so that I want because you're like an art person kan, and I think macam through whatever you do, macam whatever you paint, whatever you draw, you feel it ba. Tapi orang lain akan nampak apa ini dia buat gitu kan, akan ada orang yang begitu. So macam and then like certain orang sejak paham what yang kau draw lah, whatever you drew, whatever you painted. So there are probably 5% of your audience wouldn't understand. So I wrote that from the woman's perspective. I'm not young already, but I'm old already, ba. I mean, I'm no longer in my, you know, zaman muda-muda punya umur yang ko enjoy, and I think I have matured from there, ba, kan? So I think the type of rant that I write on my journal or whatever, kan, it becomes dia membesar jadi adult lah. I no longer write about cinta monyet gitu, cause I don't feel it anymore, kan? So bila saya tulis ni kan, I also dwell dalam perasaan woman lah, especially when someone breaks them. Dia semestinya dalam relationship, in whatever things lah. When someone breaks them, when someone crushes them to the ground, you know, and how they slowly pick up all the pieces together, walaupun it cannot sambung anymore, you know, just to move forward. Begitu, because in our society these days kan, I think macam women also needs to know their worth bah, kan? Kadang-kadang bila kau kena tinggal laki lah, you know, they become so yalah suicidal, you know, like very depressed, and it kills you.
And yeah. And recently I see a lot of sharings yang pasal victim blaming.
Mm-hmm.
And most of them women lah.
Mm.
And I think ate anak is doing something about victim blaming. Banyak kamu share tu kan? I mean, it's no longer an issue yang niche bah. Jadi it's the whole society sudah.
Mm.
Where I'm going with this is, do you feel like your, did, I mean, I know you have your own hopes and dreams about this release. Kau dah terfikirkah it might save lives?
I don't know if it might save lives or not lah, but I hope that whoever, you know, listens to it and rasa like whatever they feel when listening to music, I hope it heals them. Yeah.
That's
I don't want, perfect word. You know, I don't want women to be like, you know, so depressed and feel like they're useless after someone breaks them. Tapi from a guy's perspective, kenapa aku rasa? I want to know lah, because kan kadang-kadang lelaki ini dong dah paham apa perasaan perempuan bah.
Dia paham.
Bukanlah sebelang women empowerment sangat pun kan.
Lelaki bodoh.
Sometimes they don't know what we want gitu. I mean it's hard to understand. Diorang bilang kan perempuan fikir dari hati, lelaki pakai otak ja. You know what I mean? Like this. Okay. You know this, but we feel it tau.
And okay, sebagai seorang lelaki, this is what we discussed dulu lah. I mean,
stress lah ya.
Apa?
Stress lah kawan. You feel like you're being attacked kan ni?
Tidak juga.
Oh, tidak.
I'm a touchy feely person.
Mm-mm.
So things like this is okay. Surrounded by female figures in my life. Yeah.
Strong ones.
Your friend, my wife.
She's strong.
Men can run sprints. Women can run marathons.
Yeah, I think so.
And I guess in a short run, men can do a lot of things. Tapi dia penat. Mungkin this is when kami sudah dapat tackle perempuan. Kami dapat.
Oh, terus kau berhenti di sana lah.
That's the disease yang saya I see, and at a certain point saya rasa saya pun one of the runners juga yang penat. Terus yang we have to like constantly remind each other yang we don't want this. Kebanyakan kali bini lah yang kasih ingat yang kenapa aku tidak romantik sudah gitu kan. So I would bring topics like this to my friends and bercerita the guys lah kenapa lelaki gini. Oh, habis perempuan tiap pandai begini. So kita cari lain lah. Ini yang kalau di tempat kerja yang I guess
aku tengok dia jadi macam benda normal.
It's a joke
mencari
lah,
lain yeah. Kan?
But then
yeah.
It would be much more fun if that cari lain you kasih balik sama bini kau bah.
Yeah.
You cari lain versions of her. Like I have no idea what, but you I guess you need to reappreciate.
You're digging a hole for yourself, Nikan, now.
I'm dead a long time ago.
Oh, purik.
Bila my relatives, my parents ada yang kata yang oh sudah berapa lama kahwin, so kita mau kahwin balik.
Mm.
Oh, my in-law pun ada baru-baru. So sekarang macam saya faham sudah lah. Dulu-dulu kan yang kenapa mau kahwin balik, sudah kahwin lagi. So when this thing happens kan, it reminds you that oh it's special, it's a good thing. Yang oh terus yang I'm part of this. Yang even kalau kau di belakang pun kan, yang orang lain yang kahwin tapi macam apa orang panggil kalau kau masak air itu melimpah tempat kau bah.
Mm.
Terus yang kau pun yang rasa oh it's so rewarding to be part of this.
Mm.
And I guess if you can put in effort in your relationship with your spouse, with your partners,
mm.
To feel that past tingle, fire, fun, bodoh, yeah, moment. It can be cinta monyet again.
Yeah. Well, I think kan emotions wear off pa. Macam baju juga, dia bukan baru saja selalu bahkan. But it depends on how you jaga it patuh. Begitu. And I mean I am not the same person I used to be probably 15 years ago ba. I grow out of my old self and I become someone else. I mean, you know, not yang kau bilang I become someone else, like, you know, totally I lupa who I am gitu.
That's
kan.
Midlife
that's
crisis.
That's sot lah. That's gila. What I mean is, macam you become mature lah in a way kan. Yes. Like, you know, and whatever you're thinking is macam currently compared to what you used to have 15 years ago, it is memang so different. Because why? I have kids, you know. I cannot macam contoh, I cannot not have a job because I have a family.
Mm.
I provide for the family, begitu. So it's that type of thinking lah. It creates you, it makes you become someone else, begitu, which is an older version of yourself lah, yang lagi matang lah saya rasa, begitu. Yeah, am I making sense?
Yes.
Okay.
Tapi serius, kita terlalu serius.
Yeah.
Okay. After this album, are we anticipating something from Rich? Dia punya lirik yang
what,
bukan
like,
saya lupa but, tapi kan
like apa? An album?
I mean a comeback. Like let's say lah, let's say lah.
I don't think so lah, because kan macam kalau saya sama Rich kan, I really don't kacau whatever his creative ideas are.
Okay.
Yeah. So he does what he wants to do. And he also macam thankfully macam he doesn't dictate on things that is not like not his apalah. Dia punya kerja lah contoh lah kan. So kalau kau tengok my music and his music pun is quite so different lah.
Yeah.
He listens to something else, I listen to something else begitu. Yeah.
The only time yang saya rasa macam I can hear both of you in one song or the influence is like both of yours is during COVID.
Oh, itu.
The lockdowns?
Oh, lama sudah gitu kan. Yeah.
Other than that kan saya rasa macam Velvet is sangat Velvet and Rich is so
yeah.
Rich. There's no susah kamu, you have to like dig deep yang maybe dia ada tolong sikit, maybe, but susah.
Yeah.
Do you get that from people?
I do, and you know, like, I'll help you with the music. It was like it's always macam, you know, it's like he does the music for me. Gitu, I said, oh, this time tidak gitu. Yeah, so macam. Yeah, he does his own thing, I do my own thing lah.
Alright.
I mean, I think it's good that way because he's got his own space. He's got his own creative space, which I don't want to kacau. Because, yalah, like you, so life. Suddenly someone comes and, you know, ruin your painting and adds, like, a different hue to your colors.
That would be Maya.
What would you do? You'd be like, Mayu take lah all. Gitu kan. So I think that it is macam sama juga dalam when you create macam a song lah. You really have to, you know, if pun kalau kau mau work together bukan sama laki sama whoever lah. If you want to work together mesti dia ada that character yang tiada ego. You have to drop kasih turun your ego when you want to write something, because orang-orang kreatif ni saya rasa dia sensitive people. Kan cepat terasa, and then some people express it and some they're unable to express it, jadi dia simpan saja. So dia macam dia pendam lah begitu. Kan
kau ada banyak kah ada few songs with Masha? What's it like working with her?
Okay juga, yeah. So it's like So Masha and I has got different. We listen to very different genres.
Okay.
Yeah. So dalam ini project yang we do also, but mesti ada give and take. Mesti ada. We have to meet in the middle juga. Saya rasa everyone who buat project together perlu meet in the middle. Because there are always masa-masa yang you wouldn't agree with this certain apa, and yang satu pun tidak akan agree. So dia perlu ada dia punya garisan where you agree lah. And I think it's good juga begitu.
Is easy to achieve? I mean, saya rasa dua-dua kamu macam powerhouse gitu.
Well, I think it is lah juga sebab kan Masha has this thing for visual, sangat bagus.
Okay.
She knows. She can imagine. She puts her heart and soul into visuals. Contoh macam dalam MV, okay? Itu dia semua tur. You handle that one because I know she's
very
really good at it, and she's got a really good taste with style and all. Siapa kamu anu mah? Dia, she wants this type of look, and you know she has to achieve it. That's her, and that one I give it to her because she's really good at it. So, and also macam on the writing side, I'll do it lah, begitu juga. But we both can have our says lah. Dalam whatever we do lah. Macam contoh, if macam she said the lyric is to begini, okay, maybe we can change into something else, begitu. Yeah. So it's all about compromising lah dalam when you collaborate. Yeah.
Anyone you cannot work with?
I mean, I don't
have
tell
to mention
you.
Names lah.
Ada juga, iya. Ada. I cannot tell.
I mean,
not because I don't want to lah. Because
periuk nasi lah.
Bukan. Tidaklah pasal periuk nasi. Macam everyone gets a piece of cake pun kan. But with Masha, I'm so selesa with her already. But we're both so comfortable with each other sudah. So we know. We know. Macam kau tahu sahlah, kau tepe cakap pun, I know what you're thinking already gitu. Yeah. So it's easy lah. And we've been apa, friends since so lama sudah kan.
You guys from the same batch?
No, they're different. Oh. So we...
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, they're line. Yeah.
Line batch. But we've been good friends for so long sudah. So I think, you know, I understand her, she understands me begitu. So it's easy to work together. Because if I feel kalau macam kau mau work sama people yang you don't know kan, sebelum kau kerja sama tu orang, kau akan ada banyak assumption. So sometimes those assumption will lead to something that is not good. Dia begini. So I think before working with people kan, you have to create a chemistry. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think. So that's why macam if saya sama Masha, I feel like yeah, we both have the chemistry lah.
Can you work like that with Rich?
That's a tough question. Laki bini lah, itu kau boleh work sama N kah? No kan?
No.
There you go.
Yeah.
I'm not saying no lah. I mean, we're both in the same line juga.
But
kan?
It's possible lah.
It is possible. But probably, yeah, they'll be like, anu lah.
Macam, dia balas balik lah kan?
Dia macam... I don't know. Maybe can lah. I think so. Yeah, like... I think Ken and
but
Rich.
But that
Rich
one song yang you guys sang together, what really specially?
Rich has got a really strong character, especially when he writes also. So I wouldn't wanna be menyampuk in that ano. So when I contoh lah, macam kalau kau taruh Ajinomoto dalam itu sup, dia bilang teh sedap, dia bilang sedap by thing, and then like. But if you don't want, it becomes like that lah kalau laki bini kan.
You end up having 5 soups.
Yeah. And then like, you know, it becomes that way. But, yeah, maybe can. I would love to.
Macam siok tu tau. A challenge lah gitu.
No, but I think, you know, he's focusing on something else lah kali. Yeah.
Talking about growing up, getting older, your mates, your batch mates from AF, they know about this album coming out?
Tidak juga lah. I mean, I'm not so close to them juga sudah these days. Macam we're not quite in contact. Yeah, so with Farhan, just... I am lah. I'm still in contact with Farhan. Yeah.
I'm imagining Farhan in my head.
Yeah, and Lotte, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Lotte, yeah. Do you see them with this? I mean, are they growing with this kind of maturity? Atau...
I don't know.
Kau siang makin tua ni?
I don't judge people. I mean...
No, I mean...
Yeah, like, I don't really, you know, macam look into their lives, but I think we all live a different kind of life sudah sekarang. So macam we've got our own priorities, you know, different priorities. So I think yalah probably mature lah ba. Sama pula, lebih kurang pula umur
macam,
kami tu.
Macam now with this album macam saya mau dengar lagi yang what if Farhan comes up with songs of post AF singers.
Yeah, she's got a really nice voice, kan?
Powerful, eh? Because this is happening to you. So imagine if your batch satu-satu keluar, like.
Well, to make this album pun kan, again, I think it requires a lot of time, a lot of energy, a lot of effort, and yeah. It's not easy because the resources are kurang here juga. And while making this album, thankfully I have, like, you know, really good friends lah yang betul-betul I can say macam part of this album, which are my dalam music punya part lah, my guitarist and also my bassist lah, he plays the keys, Andy. Also Andy and also Brandon. You know, we have this type of friendship yang memang yalah yang rapat lah, and you know they are also passionate musicians, and apa tu, the good thing is we work in the same company. So when I came up with this idea of creating, because I don't do my music alone, I don't play everything sendiri, just certain things that I'll just come out with a demo, and after that when I'm done with my demo, I let the guys listen lah, these two guys, to dengar if it's okay or not, how do we work on, you know, guitar, how do we work on the keys, and all these little instruments lah. So I'm so thankful that, you know, they also sacrificed their time for this album, because I told them when we started, I said, guys, this is like a crazy idea lah kan. I think I said to them early this year, 2003, I told them I want to come out with an English album more. But apa tu? I want to kasih release it macam this year juga.
Keplau otak kau.
And like, they're not like, what? Gitu. Uy, pemarilah. Like that, you know? So, but do you think can kato, ah? Like within a year? Because even macam mau tulis satu lagu pun payah lah kadang-kadang when you don't have those ideas coming in, kan? So, they're like, you know, they were, anu juga lah. I mean, they were quite supportive juga, and they really wanted to be part of it lah. And I think, macam, without them juga kan, I don't think I'm able to come out with those type of music. Yeah, those type of feel. Yeah, because semua pemain music, instrument ni kan, dorang ada lain-lain feel kan. So it requires all those type of efforts lah, macam you have to find a day to jam together. Dia jadi macam, oh, jadi orang muda balik begitu. And plus we're like working adults, we have our day job lah, in a way kan, lagi susah, we're not full-time musicians. Yeah, so this is, you know, the album is made out of passion. You know, it won't make money lah kalau kau di Sabah kan, you know.
It's a deal. Can we change that narrative?
You won't make money with music lah, yeah. And that's what they always say. And it's, sadly, it's so true. So people who makes music here, they call it passion project, which is a passion project di Sabah.
It's code word for no income lah.
I mean, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, begitu. It's sad lah. But then, I think I dalam ni album I put my heart and soul in it. Yeah. And there are days when I cried listening to the songs that
sangat
I write.
Feel okay.
Itu, you know. And I think I said if I don't release the album this year, like, if I don't push myself to, kasi complete it by 2023. Next year memang setelah mood sudah mau buat. It's so draining up until one point kau rasa macam okay, I cannot record the vocals like how I used to sound in the demo. It's different. It's like that.
Oh.
Yeah. So when I come back to that song after I finish kan, I wanna do the vocals. Say lah kan. You have to channel that feeling again to be in that situation.
Oh my god.
Begitu. I rasa lah begitu. Because if I channel a different type of aura kan, dia jadi lain. So towards like the end of this album punya journey lah kan, okay, I say okay, mau mati sudah dia punya
vibe.
Yeah, I feel lah, I just have to finish it lah. Begitu. If I drag, because okay, saya jenis kadang-kadang I like to procrastinate mah. And some benda-benda in my life I do halfway. Hangat-hangat tai ayam. So I said, okay, this is not something yang saya buat hangat-hangat tai ayam lah. Begitu. And it wasn't easy because to untuk membuat album ni, it requires money juga. Kan? It requires a huge amount of money. Why? Because you have to pay your sessionist. Yalah, you don't work with your friends for free, kan? You have to pay someone to mix the song, gitu, and it requires money. Everything requires money these days. So, you want to have something good. I mean, something decent, something nice yang kau rasa mix kau okay sudah, kau punya produk okay sudah, kan? You have to spend money. So it's something very difficult juga. But I don't know how we managed to pull through, kan? Macam during that time lah. Yeah, it's like, wow, we actually did it all begitu. Because orang pun cakap saya gila. Like someone, just some random guy lah. Why are you like, macam... He didn't say crazy lah. He just said like, well, why 14 songs ah? Macam she just come out with a single.
14 songs?
14.
I was listening to 14 songs.
You listen until finish meh.
Sampai fin dia bilang.
Oh. Yeah, it's 14 songs lah. So.
Because I wasn't paying attention. I was just streaming it over and over the office, Pemcha Drive. And I remembered when we discussed the date of this interview, Debbie was saying, oh, mau kasih siap dulu this songs. And
yeah, I don't want to come here and, you know, when you interview me, I got nothing to say.
At that time, I thought it was like 3-4 lagu. Terus yang, so I was streaming, terus yang, okay, 4 songs lah ni kan. And terus ada lagi lepas tu yang, berapa lagu dia silang. And I thought it was in a loop. Tapi macam ini lain lagi oh. Ini lain. But the feeling maintained in that state of emotion. Okay, I'm going to go somewhere deeper. Sorry lah saya tanya ni.
Dive.
But recently you lost someone very special. And did that affected the
process?
Yeah,
I think it did. A lot of things macam, you know, happened this year kan? So it did, and it, you know, it was macam it was delayed lah. But while, you know, while my dad was still here kan, we were still alive, and you know, while we were taking care of him juga, at the same time I was also working on the songs lah juga. And bukan saja the album lah saya buat ni tahun, I have like ada project, side project, like songs yang I buat yang bukan album. So that was also part yang draining, because the other project was something that you have to, it's got a deadline. So you want to finish your album, but you still have to do that one. So it's like both, and it's and also my dad punya situation kan. He was already like, so you know, the nut sudah ada time. So it's like everything lah going on dalam masa yang sama. So it was quite macam, why about I do all this ah gitu. At that time lah macam, you question yourself lah, why, what do you want to achieve actually ah? Why do you want to do all these things ah? Gitu. Like, why do you, what are you trying to prove to actually want to complete all these songs? Begitu. But I tell myself lah macam, I don't want to prove anything pun. Bila saya keluar dengan ini album, I just feel like, you know, it's like a book lah ba. I come out with, I'm done with that. So this is what I did. Gitu. Something like that. So yeah, macam so banyak things yang apa happen this year, and macam it didn't stop me from doing what I want to do lah. Yeah.
Is this album going to be something physical?
Well, a lot of people are asking kan. At first we didn't want to, because macam our previous album we printed a lot. And
but this is tidak different. Jalan,
yeah. But that one was a compilation of singles lah. Mm. And I just feel like I didn't quite, you know, curate something dalam itu benda. It's okay. Just songs yang I buat, I compile together. But for this English punya, I don't know. It's like so meaningful to me. And macam I betul-betul put my everything into it.
Mm.
It's so intricate.
I mean, I, like, I don't know marketing.
Macam mini bag kan. I also don't know marketing again.
But I want to be a part of this. Like, if you have like CDs kan, saya mau ni, because it's something yang, it's a feeling I get when I listen to those songs yang I feel like I'm part of that.
Yeah, so mula-mula tiada. We don't plan to come up with a physical album at first. Tapi macam a lot of people are asking. So I was, cause yelah, we say like, who listens to CD these days? Dalam kereta diorang pun, ada yang kereta baru, they don't have a CD player bah. So they will pasang the Bluetooth and listen to Spotify or iTunes ka, apa kan. So kami macam, sudahlah, I mean, I consider myself as an indie singer kan, indie artist. And then like, you know, waste money again to print CDs. And then, no one will buy it bah. And kalau saya kan, like I say, I don't put a benchmark on my creation. So I don't know who listens to me. I don't know who can relate to my music. So it's always those negative things that plays around with my mind lah. Macam nobody will, you know, you come out with CDs also, nobody will buy it ba. They wouldn't listen. Who listens to my music? But then, dalam ni lagu kan, dalam ni album, macam I just thought to myself, and I talk to Debla, I think we should have juga. We should have a CD, just because.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you want to make it macam something nice juga, something that is too precious to be thrown away. Kan kalau CD banyak bah kita dapat dulu, ada yang dibuang aja bagian.
But
something yang you don't keep.
I feel lah kan, usually when artist kasih keluar album kan, oh belilah si kami punya album, cuma 15.99 sen begitu kan. And you recognize that as marketing, dia mau jual mau untung. But this one kan, it feels like you're providing some kind of a, you're giving people the chance to be a part of this, ma. To feel this. Saya sangat feel ni bila it comes to this album. And I guess kalau saya ada CD, I won't play it juga. I'll still go to Spotify. But
rugi lah.
But owning apa? That kan.
Seprint rugi. You don't listen pun nyoka.
Yes, we'll play it. But it's like I was part of this Velvet Pia journey when she made that. Begitu ba? I mean, you guys drop a comment ka, kasih share and tell us like what do you feel about. I mean, kamu pergi dengar lagi lagu dulu, dengar dulu, hadam, and come back here, give a comment, and see if we can get the ball rolling lah, gitu kan?
Yeah, I think I don't know if people can relate to it, pun. I think what I can say about the album, it's about, you know, it's like the other side of myself, you know, like. Something that I'm so takut to, I'm so scared to show to people. It's like
too late.
Kau tahu ke apa orang Melayu bilang macam membuka pekung di dada. It's like
what is pekung?
Itu kata, it's like you're exposing yourself, like that side of you, gitu. And
you being vulnerable, gitu lah.
Yeah, and definitely kan, you know, people will start questioning. Yeah.
Oh, pekung, it is pekung.
Pekung kan, pandai kan saya. So it's
itu
like
ibu
that.
Ibu
yeah.
Itu.
But then, macam, like I say, you only live once. So, I don't know if I'm able to come out with these type of
writings
in the future again. Yeah. Begitu.
Uy, time teh?
4 kali sudah.
Oh, 1 jam lebih lah sudah ni. Uff, okay.
Kau bilang teh mau lama kan?
macam boleh rap juga sudah ni. Siok sudah dia punya.
Tapi kau tanya lagi lah, apa kau mau, apa lagi kau mau tahu?
Okay. Coba.
Oh, physical album. Apa tuh? Oh my. Kiano kah?
Oh, kalau yang kau rasakan pasang physical ini sebab saya tidak bercakap saya muda dari kamu ke apa, tapi memang kata rasa muda lah.
Sangat.
Tapi saya punya Amin, saya punya orang-orang umuran saya kan memang masih mau pegang fisikal sebab kami punya orang kan masih mau nampak itu barang pegang itu barang
rasa
bos, iya. So kalau mau cakap yang Spotify Bluetooth begitu kan macam bukan biasa post di jalan raya saja sambil dengar lagu kamu atau apa kan. Dan kalau miliki itu fisikal lain itu dia punya feeling so macam biarpun kami di batch-batch bawah yang itu muda-muda begitu kan masih lagi excited mau ada
ya kak
ya betul masih tentu lah kami masih simpan physical punya barang
kan abis orang bilang kan nobody listens to CD these days kan begitu but well mau juga I want also to keluar like but I have to make it nice something very artsy juga lah bukan sekadar punya kulit, oh, okay. You wanna make it macam buku, a hardcover book, contoh lah. It's
saya, got saya that. Saya mau satu ah.
Okay, kalau lah saya buatkan, should I gitu kan? So I want it to be
personalized.
Yeah, macam I want it to be a work of art.
Dear Egan,
gitu. You know, like how you buka buku tentu yang beza hardcover sama yang ya, ya begitu. Dia jadi cerita macam kau baca buku begitu. Sebab ada tau jenis-jenis album yang kau dengarkan yang betul-betul, walaupun bukan pasal kau kan, dia macam, oh sakitnya.
It's talking to you.
And then you fall in love with the singer yang you just heard randomly, kan begitu. So you wanna follow apa lagi? What's his story like? So you wanna know, yeah, whether it's based on his personal relationship kah, ataupun dia punya life, orang lain punya life, ataupun through the lens yang dia tengok begitu.
You know what I felt when a few songs, your few songs.
What, you felt attacked? Bukan, as a guy.
Bukan. Saya rasa macam, macam saya mau, siapa kacau kau ni? Siapa yang buat kau begini ni?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Mari.
Yeah, I know. Ada kawan saya.
Saya settlekan untuk kau begitu.
Siapa mau kasih rusak hati kau ni?
Yeah, it's like a call to action yang. Siapa yang nyanyi ni lagu macam mari sini kita geng. Begitu ba? Ya ya ya, solidarity. It felt like that ni.
Ya yeah, kan, because when I wrote it kan, bila saya buat tu I really felt it. Macam dia punya, and I the words that I write kan macam it betul-betul kasih gitu. But I'm okay.
Okay.
I'm fine.
How do we wrap this up? Sangat feel. Velvet. I guess kita pergi soalan-soalan generic lah kan.
Okay.
What's your, I guess what's your take? What's your aim? What's your hope for this album? Apa yang kau mau?
Apa saya mau?
Like now you've done the emotional bit. You've done the hard part of not sensing your emotions.
Yeah, but my words also.
So sekarang apa kau mau?
Actually kan, saya tidak mau papa sudah. No, seriously speaking, kan, I don't want anything sudah because I've completed it. I managed to finish my album. I managed to put everything in macam an album. I managed to put an album together, ba. When macam all these months, kan, I was actually questioning myself, ba. And I always macam tell myself I can, memang tidak akan siap ni, tidak akan, I cannot do it begitu. But I just macam for now, macam I told Debbie macam, well I feel after I've completed everything, I feel nothing sudah. Macam saya sudah siap ini album. I've the listening party also, it's already done. You know, I did my part, and I'm just waiting for the album to be released. So, what I want from this kan is, you know, dalam ni album we've got plans lah. Of course, macam dalam when you make something, of course you want to market it. But I'm not good with marketing. Okay, I just create things, and Debbie does all the things lah. To apa market it, but we don't do tidak juga banyak lah macam semua DIY. I don't have a label, like we're our own label, and I'm okay with it, you know. So for next year lah, for this album, my angan-angan is to, you know, have a live showcase to perform this song, all the songs in the album. Yeah, because I've never done a showcase where I get to showcase all my writings. Mostly if people invite you to sing, they have their set list. They choose what they want from you. So it's always the songs yang, the other songs that I write.
The hits like it on it.
In a way, yes. So what I wanna do is, you know, I just wanna perform the album live, and I love an intimate crowd lah, sajalah, just small one gitu. Yeah, and I hope I can do it.
Imagine kalau kau boleh tapis kau punya crowd yang datang, kau pernah disakiti? Tidak pernah. Okay, tiapa ya. Tiapa masuk.
But thing is kan, who would wanna come juga? Ah, gitu. So you don't know, begitu. Like, but that's what I wanna do lah. Because tidak. No, I mean, I think. Saya rasa saya punya view sama benda-benda sekarang kan lain sudah bah. So I just want people who loves music to come and I'll tengok the show. Ya, yeah, begitu. So I just wanna play good music. Itu aja. With the guys that I work with because I think they deserve the stage juga.
Yeah.
They've been working so hard to make the album happen. Andy and also Brandon, you know, and you know, Debbie, I have like a few friends, Daryl, siapa lagi ya? Wanda, Lester gitu,
thank
you know.
Very much.
They're the ones who yang paling kuat nih, ha. Macam aku pulang lah sudah, what time already gitu. You know, sampai yang kena suruh pulang lah because I spend so much time stressing out on things that I'm not supposed to stress on. Stress about. So, you know, I just want it to be a show that's stress free lah. But of course every performance kecil-kecil punya pun you get so nervous kan. But then that's what I wanna, I don't know what I wanna do. And we have planned something also lah to do a showcase. Macam in few venues sudah, but I think I can't share the details yet lah because I don't wanna jinx it. Nanti saya cakap besar saja kan, but that's what I plan to do lah for this album and you know I just hope that you know people ada masa untuk listen to it lah. Listen to it yes, don't dwell sangat lah.
Right.
Yeah, but yalah, this is for the broken-hearted lah ba. It's not a happy love song pun. I don't know how to write. Yeah, I don't know how to write love songs. And I don't even have a love song.
Even in the singles
also
together.
Oh.
Yeah.
Extreme one.
Yeah.
Ramai-ramai depressed.
Yeah, I don't know. That's why lah kalau orang bawanya ni macam kawin kan. I've got no love songs in my list. I don't know how to write love songs.
Ate, last question. Tersakiti lah, feel.
Kau pernah kena sakit?
Itu kita save untuk episode yang lain. It needs its whole trilogy.
Oh, itu sakit itu kan.
Any last words?
Well, thanks for having me again.
Thank you very much.
And yeah, I hope you guys can go listen to the album. It's already out. It's out on the 30th actually.
We'll give a link to it lah.
Yeah, and thank you so much for supporting my music, whoever you are, you know, and this is my, apalah, my new, bukan produk lah kan, this is like an art that
anak
I wanna present to you guys, the latest art, yeah, and I hope you guys get to listen to it lah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you for all this. And thank you for another guest of mine said thank you for making this holy. If you sacrifice this much of your emotions, your time, your segala-galala, you have just made it holy.
Really?
And
I mean,
it's really secret.
Well, it consumes and you lah, but I don't think ay macam
eh sudah
perlu kasih
terima
gitu. Thank you.
And I'm really happy to hear a song that is not Cinta Monyet in this lifetime in Sabah, made by a Sabahan. So I guess on that
who
note,
said it's not Cinta Monyet?
Well, the sad part is not monyet anymore lah. Masalah, habislah.
Dan Wedana.
Apa saya mau cakap? Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe, whatever that thing is that you do. On behalf of the Sip Sip family, yeah, support us. Continue to support us. We try to bring you. We try not to see the quantity lah. We try to see the quality of our interviews, of the topics that we bring. We might not have a lot of followers, but the engagement that we get is really powerful lah. So. we're contemplating on going to Spotify. That's why we have all these mics now, and we have no idea how to do it now. But drop a comment, Marta. We can talk about that topic. Okay, Igan, Ate, Ahmad masih di Thailand. So okay lah, bye bye lah. Good night. See ya.